Hi guys, welcome to How to BIM. In this video, I'm going to show you how to choose the best setup in your Clash Detective tool in order to get the most appropriate or accurate results in your Clash Detective report. Now let's get started. First, we'll open the Clash Detective tool. So if this is your first time performing clash detection, I recommend you watch my previous video. It's a step-by-step tutorial to show you how to perform the test and how to export your clashes report. But for this video, I'm going to show you the advanced features of the Clash Detective tool. So if you need for certain reason in your project to ignore clashes between items in the same layer or the same group or block or cell, or even in the same file if you're embedding multiple files, you should check one of these boxes in order to get the best or the most accurate results in your clashes report. The next tab we have is the Select tab. So in the Select tab, we will have two boxes, Section A and Section B. They are both identical. They have the same elements and the same options. For example, we'll choose the standard option. In this option, we will find a list of all the elements in our model organized alphabetically. You'll find the same list in both boxes, and you can find the same list as well in the selection tree, which is pinned on the left side of my screen. Well, if this is your first time using Navisworks, I recommend you watch my first video in this playlist. It shows you how to set up your workspace if you're just starting using Navisworks. Otherwise, you can find the selection tree in the home menu in the Select and Search. So next we have the Compact option, which is a simplified version of the standard tree hierarchy I've shown you before, and it's narrowed down to items, so you can only see the items. Then we have the Properties, which shows you all the items in the model based on their properties like category or material or location or element ID. Obviously, we can find the same properties in both selection boxes. The last option is the sets. I have shown you how to create sets in the previous video. You can watch it if you don't know how to. Otherwise, it's pretty simple. It's actually very simple when you use the Find Item tool. Now we'll go to the options right under the selection boxes. We have the three first buttons, which will help us choose what type of object we want to include in the clash test. So the first button is the surfaces button. If I click on this button, I will make sure that during the test, all clashes between any surfaces that are intersecting will be detected. This is what we usually use when working with surfaces in 3D models like today's Revit 3D model. The second button will help us detect clashes between lines. But why would this be important? So if I'm an MEP engineer and I want to detect clashes between my pipes, but not the 3D solid geometry of the pipe, but the center line of it. So if I press on this button, I will be making sure that I am detecting the clashes between the center lines of the pipes only. So this is how this button can be important. The third button can help us detect clashes between points. For example, if I'm working with points clouds and I want to detect clashes between them, I can choose or select this button to get accurate results. Obviously, if you click on all three of these buttons, you'll be detecting clashes between all of these three types of geometries. Next, we have the self-intersect button, which can tell us or detect if any element has any conflict with itself in the same box. But I don't really recommend this button because it may detect any object that has a connection with itself. It may detect it as a clash, and it will give you an unrealistic number of clashes in your report that are not accurate. Now we'll pass to the last two buttons, which can either help us select elements from the scene and include them into the clash detection, or select or highlight the elements that are already included in the clash detection in the scene. As you can see here, for example, let's go to set selection tree and select any element in our boxes. I'm going to show you how you can visualize them in the model. For example, ceilings and columns. And we will use select in scene, and there are my walls and columns in yellow. Okay, it's not very apparent. Let's try something more. For example, we can select floors. It will show you the selection color. Yeah, for example, floors. Now we'll go down to settings, and that's where we will choose the type of the clash we're going to perform before running the test. Well, first we have hard clashes, which is the kind of clashes we've performed in the previous video. It simply detects any issues or conflicts that happen when two elements are intersecting. Next, we have hard conservative, which is when we choose this option, we will be making sure that no clashes are overlooked, which will give us a more thorough result or clash detection report. It may give you a lot of false positives, but it is very detailed, so you might need that if you have specific needs in your project. Next, we have the clearance type. The clearance type is usually set by the tolerance level. By the tolerance, we're talking about a specified distance between clashes. So when we choose clearance, there's an imaginary surface that offsets from the object we chose. And when any of these surfaces are in any conflict, our clash will be detected. The last type of clashes is duplicates. And when we choose it, we'll be simply detecting if there is any duplicates in the model, as in the same element in the same location with the same characteristics. Finally, we have link. We can choose either none or timeliner. If we choose timeliner, like this example, we'll be linking the clash test to a schedule in timeliner or an animation scene or whatsoever. And finally, the last button is to run your test. So basically, I think that's all we need to cover when it comes to the options and settings that are provided by the Clash Detective tool. Make sure that when you're running your test, you choose properly, you choose the relevant settings to your project needs to get the best results possible. And if you have any questions about the export of the test or about how to select elements, how to select elements before you run your test, or how to export a Revit model and import it into Navisworks, you could simply watch my other videos in this playlist. And obviously, if you liked my content, you could simply hit the like button or subscribe if you want to see more of it. Thank you for watching.